I use a screen reader to access the internet, my email, and all of my electronic books for school. I'm going to open up my email. I was able to just access some emails from my professors. One had a link to an internet site that will be helpful in my studies. Back on the desktop, I can open up my textbooks that were given to me in electronic format. I can also access Word documents where I'm currently writing a memo that's due in my legal writing class. I can also scan in books so that I can read them later instead of taking them home from the library, some that aren't available for checkout. I can scan them in page by page using this Pearl device, and I'm able to access everything that's in the book. When I finish turning the pages and scanning in the material that I need to read, I can then hear it from my computer.
Number 1, 4, co-geoids, 4 corner star, entire area comprising something.
I need to access the internet every day to go to a legal database website, Westlaw. It's also a source of interaction between my professors and the students. I can open up a list of links to each individual's professor's list of course materials and assignments. I also submit exams and papers via this website. And that's how I use all of my technology in my everyday life. My name is Bianca Knight, and I am originally from Murfreesboro, Tennessee. I lost the majority of my sight 3 years ago, suddenly, at the age of 27, almost overnight. It's in my family, and we did not know it was in our family because I'm the first one that's affected. I have a brother who is also in his 20s, and that's the other commonality of LHON, is that it happens very suddenly, like it did in my case, and mostly in your late 20s. I miss seeing people's faces a lot. It's awkward because I don't look visually impaired. I was actually a school teacher before. When I was accepted to Belmont, I knew that I needed to find a route in law that I wanted to study, find my niche, so to speak, for what I could do in this profession. And due to all of the accommodation issues that I had and all the red tape I've had to cut through in 3 years that I've lost my sight, I know firsthand the need for change and the need for reform. So once I felt comfortable enough to at least live with this condition, I knew it was time to tackle the technology aspect of it. I felt in the interim between sight loss and acclimation to the blindness and technology, a complete lack of independence. And with this equipment and with the services that have been provided for me, I feel almost completely independent. I had mentioned to my instructor and to the people that I met through the Disability Coalition that I'd always wanted to go to law school. And they said, there's no reason why you can't go now. Although this is a disability, is more of a major inconvenience to me and doable.